Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is DeLady Designer, and we're back with another speed build video of our city zoo. And I am just, I don't know, I just feel so happy and excited that everything is coming along so nicely. And yeah, it's just really starting to get shape. I know I start mentioning it like in every episode, but I just can't help it that I'm just really happy to see that this city zoo is really coming along so nicely. And even though the progress feels a little bit slow because we're still working on that same building, we are adding a lot of new animals, which is just really cool. Even though this episode is still about the gorilla, since we only did the indoor section, so now we are doing the outdoor section. But still, I just feel like the progress is going a little bit faster too. Like, the struggle was pretty real with like the shape of the building, and I think the dinosaur museum was like the hardest part, together with the indoor section of the gorilla, like that dome and stuff. That was taking me a lot of time, but right now I just really feel like, yeah, I can really fill in like all those empty areas. And I'm also really excited to start working on the other side, because the building is obviously inspired by the Riviera Hall of Rotterdam Zoo, and we really took a lot of inspiration of the types of animals on this wing. But the other wing, as I mentioned, like it's quite hard to see what kind of animals there are right now in Rotterdam Zoo. I think it's mostly birds and some aviaries, but all those animals are kind of like, just, we don't have them in the game. So it's going to be way more freedom on the other side, and I'm just really excited to start building some kind of really cool reptile house with maybe some crocodiles or Komodo dragons. Well, the Komodo dragon is actually also in the existing building, so that is definitely some animal that we should add in that section. But I think we just have some more freedom, maybe the Nile monitor. So I'm really curious what kind of animals you guys would like to see. Obviously, we're not there yet. We have the pygmy hippo habitat coming after this episode, and then we're having the rhino habitat, and then we're going to start with like the reptile house. I have some really cool things in my mind that I actually also had in my mind during Mailin Zoo already, but I just never had the chance to really start doing something like that. So I think the other wing will be a perfect place to start doing something really cool with a reptile house, with like a lot of trees and a bit of a jungle feeling maybe. I think we can really manage to do something really cool with that. But enough about the future, let's talk about this gorilla habitat. So the outdoor section for the gorillas, because this is basically inspired, like I mentioned, with the orangutans. I had a picture in my Discord server in the inspirational channel with like a map of Rotterdam Zoo, like probably 1988, and they had orangutans in there, and there was like some kind of layout of the outdoor section for the gorilla. So it's not like the outdoor section you would see at the moment in Rotterdam Zoo, but it's more inspired by an older version of it. And what I really liked about that is that you have some kind of water section that separates different areas of the habitat into small little islands. I obviously can't really tell if there is like super shallow water or anything, but I just went with my own inspiration in this case, and it was just like, okay, just gonna have water, and we're gonna make sure that all the islands are of course reachable for all the gorillas. It's gonna be a challenge to see if the keepers are able to reach it. So far I tried to check, but I didn't really see the keepers on the islands. I was actually looking at one of the gorillas, like, okay, if you're gonna poop, then someone should come here and use the poover and poover it away. And then all of a sudden, the poop was just gone. So I don't know if that is like a way that Planet Zoo handles it. Like, okay, if the keepers can't really reach a certain area of the habitat, the poop will just disappear, so you don't have like issues with the habitat not being cleaned or anything like that. So I don't know if that's the case, but that was just something that popped in my mind, like, maybe it works like that now. And you would also see me adding a electrical fence on the outer sections of the barriers, because I also did that at the orangutan, but I didn't really mention, but I feel like that is just like that little part of realism, like, okay, if Boquito, which is like the most famous gorilla in Rotterdam Zoo, would be thinking like, okay, I'm going to take a swim, then still maybe the electrical fence would turn him off to not do it. I don't know. It's just a little bit of a feeling of realism. Like, if they would be crazy to use the water section, then there's still like that little electric fence thingy that hopefully would make them turn around again. So what I tried to do for the islands and the climbing frame areas, I tried to look up several pictures actually. And what you mostly see with gorilla habitats, at least on the outside section, that is mostly just some big logs and some more trees with thicker branches. So I thought the cherry blossom tree would be really cool to use for this. And I tried to just blend them into each other just for a little bit to get the idea that you mostly see in real life zoos. And I had no idea if it would work. According to the traversable area, they are definitely able to climb from one side to the other side. It looks really cool, but I just have not seen them using it so far. But that could also be because of the climbing frames in the indoor section, so they don't really have that much climbing needs when they actually go outside. So I don't really know. I really hope those kind of things will be adjusted a little bit in the future with Planet Zoo, so you would just see them randomly climbing and not like, oh yeah, I already climbed, so I will not do it anymore in a different section. I don't really know how that exactly works, but it will be just really cool to see them actually climb. And as I said, like, if you just check the traversable area, you will definitely see like lines going from one tree to the other tree, and it just looks really great. I've not seen anyone doing it before in Planet Zoo. Probably people did do it, but I just didn't see it. So I was like, ah, this is actually really cool, and it really resembles the climbing frames that you would see with gorillas. So yeah, I'm just really happy with how this is turning out. The only downside of this whole habitat is that the sun is on always on the backside. So it's like, for me, I just really like to have the sun from the front, but obviously you can't really play around with the sun. So that's the only downside, that the front, if you're standing in front of it, that you always have the sun in front of you. So yeah, I don't know. That's the only downside of this whole habitat, I think. And for the outside section, the real life zoo actually had some kind of viewing platform, or like a little cabin with like educational stuff in there and things. At first I wanted to rebuild that, but I just couldn't really find a picture or anything like that of how that was really looking to get the idea of it. So in the end, I just went with something a little bit different, like to keep the style of the orangutan habitat. And it was so funny because I was finished with this habitat and someone commented on my recent video like, do you know that you can also just walk around with Google Maps in the zoo? And I was like, oh my goodness, I had no freaking idea that you could, because I was using Google Maps so often and I was using like the satellite images and the 3D images. But I totally didn't think of the fact that you could really walk around. So you can walk around in like an older version of Rotterdam Zoo just to see how everything is built up. You can even go into the Riviera Hall, even though not everywhere. So you can't go to the wings, but it's just super funny. So thank you so much again for mentioning that to me, because I was like walking around in Rotterdam Zoo yesterday all the time on Google Maps. It was just amazing, and I could actually see that cabin that I just had no idea how it would really look. But then I was like, okay, I already built this habitat, so I'm not going to change everything again. What is also very interesting, by the way, is that yesterday Rotterdam Zoo announced that they're going to invest 100 million euros to do a lot of renovations in Rotterdam Zoo again. So including the Riviera Hall will be renovated, and they will also build a new habitat for the gorilla. So that's really just a coincidence, I guess, but that's super cool. So maybe I will post, it's a Dutch article, but I will post it in the description if you're interested. There are also some art pieces or like drawings and stuff of what their plans are. And maybe we could use something like that also a little bit in the future to have like future ideas of a master plan of a zoo, and just try to see if we can create something cool out of that. Maybe that's a cool idea. And obviously, with those 100 million euros they're going to invest, they're going to do a lot more in the zoo with the rat pandas and the elephants and so many things. So definitely interesting to read. I think you can also just translate the page in English if you're not able to read Dutch. So it might be, if you're interested, you can definitely just try to translate the page and then you can still read it if you want to read more about it. It's really funny. So, wow, I have a shorter speed build, you can imagine. I'm almost done with talking and this speed build video is almost done. Wow, that's amazing. So let me just show you guys around then. Okay, so on request also, oh, what is that orangutan doing? We have a little bit more guests in the zoo at the moment. There's a big wall right over here. That's because of the pygmy hippo habitat. No spoilers yet. That will be the next episode. So we have the orangutan habitat right over here. And if you may have seen it in the last episode where I showed that habitat, it's really cool to see them using this, even though it's a little bit glitchy. I had like a very straight wall here and I wasn't really happy with it. So I made it like a round one with like all those little trim pieces. I think that looks way better just because we have a lot of round shapes overall at this building. So here we have the Gorilla Islands and it's, I really like how this turned out with like all those trees. As you can see, if you stand over here, it's like a lot of darker colors because the sun is right on the other side, which is a pity, but it is what it is. But it's really cool. We even have a little baby gorilla. And I added these kind of planks, so just to see if the keepers would be able to reach the other side. I have one hidden away here too. I think this one can be used, but there isn't really anything on this island except for some poop to clean. And this is definitely something you would see a lot in real life zoos with gorilla habitats, like those big logs. And I added some of these cherry blossom trees. It's like very simple, but it definitely is, yeah, at least what I've seen resembles a lot of the gorilla habitats in real life. So that is really cool. As I said, I have not seen them climbing or anything like that, which is kind of a pity. But if we go to heat maps, traversable area, and then click one of the gorillas. We need to change that name, Boquito. There you go, Boquito is now in our zoo. So, oh, I clicked it, no. Okay, there you go. So if you can see the traversable area, you can see that they are able to climb from one side to the other side, which is actually really cool. You can really see the connection. So I can only hope to see them climb here and really enjoy this particular area. But as I said, it might be because of the climbing frames we already have indoors. But still, at least they go outside, so that's really good. And hopefully with like maybe some slight changes of Planet Zoo, of how the animals work, they will be able, or we just have to have some more patience. I guess that could also be a thing. And as I said, like, this one hasn't been used yet by the keepers, so I guess they're not able to reach it here. So that is something I could definitely try and change to see if that would at least be able to work, because it would be cool if people are standing here to see the gorillas on that side. And other than that, I just really, really am happy with how this is coming along together with like this building. So we have like this green here, which I did on purpose. I wanted to like close this section off. And you can see the door for the keepers right over here. So if we just walk here, I really wanted this to be dense so that the people would not, basically not stop here to look at the gorillas. And then we have this section right over here for our keeper to go to its keeper's hut, and it would be able to see the gorillas a little bit from here. Like, I don't know if they need to, but it's not for the guests, at least it's really only for staff. So that's why I like use the natural path right over here, and there's like a little piece of a staff path section right over here, so only the staff would use it. I know that someone mentioned it for like the entrance part with the staff area, where I just used this path section, and someone was like, yeah, but you can use like a little section for the staff path to make sure that the guests would not walk there. So, but I didn't do that because I didn't want to close it off. But for that kind of section, I don't really mind. So this would be the front of the building. And as I mentioned here, would be like the reptile house as I was talking about. And I think it's going to look super cool once this is all going to be finished and some more green in front of it and some picnic benches maybe. So yeah, I'm really, really happy and excited about this whole section and how it's coming along. And the Pygmy Hippo habitat is almost finished, so soon there will be another episode of our city zoo, so hopefully you guys will like that. And then we're going to do the rhino habitat right over there, and then this whole wing will be finished, so that's super cool. I'm really excited to see how that is going to look once it is finished, and then we're gonna start on the other side. It's going to be super awesome. So let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this section for the gorillas. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe of course if you haven't already. And I just really look forward to read all your comments, and I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye guys!